to forget her. I can't seem to get her off my mind. I thought I'd never miss her, but I found out somehow. I think about her almost all the time.
It was a quiet country in 1945. I was here as a war correspondent when the Americans came over to accept the surrender of Jap troops below the 38th parallel. I remembered how restful the green rice paddies looked. The peaceful villages and towns like Taejong. It didn't amount to much like any small town anywhere, but it was home to these people. I remembered it all when I came back to Korea 5 years later, again as a war correspondent. Again with American and other United Nations troops bringing liberation. I was glad I remembered because so much of it was gone. The towns, the public buildings, the people destroyed by war. This time there was no celebration and no gaiety. Tanks and boats paraded in the streets. And the air was filled with bullets, not confetti. And everywhere lay the murdered dead. The scenery of destruction is monotonous. Atrocity stories keep repeating themselves. Of course, some atrocities will not be counted at all, because they were perpetrated on the living. Atrocities of the spirit. The heartbreak. The shattered families. The broken lives. More of this. Let us not forget this. For our sake, as well as for the rest of the world. If we value our lives, our homes, and our freedom, let us remember the crime of Korea. Thank you.